So the most anticipated visit to Costco. Costco's opened its first branch in New Zealand. It's in Auckland, west of Auckland. So I'm just taking a walkthrough because there was a big queue to actually get a trolley, although I have a membership card so I could easily walk in. So let's go and have a look around. And what is this? Bose TV soundbar, $399.99. I haven't compared electronics with the actual price with the other competitors, but I would most likely be able to comment on the grocery prices. That's something I'm mostly aware of on a daily basis. The sound seems good. Bose has always been my first choice in terms of speakers. JBL, this looks bulky, looks pretty flash for a good party. There's an actual piano here. I don't have a clue how to play this. Looks good. Again, not sure about the prices because I can't see a ticket here. Let's see on the left side, what else can we see? There are some headphones, some kids walkie-talkies. And that is a magnet car phone holder. That's good. I probably need it, but probably in the next visit. What is this? USB-C to USB-A cable. It actually tells, what is the 80 kg one? Probably it's how strong it is. Some chargers. What else is interesting here? I'm actually walking a bit faster in the aisles that is busy so that I don't block the other customers. So excuse me if the video is blur at all. This TV, again, there's no price here though. For some there is, for some there's not. There's TV wall mount. On the left side, this is pretty cool. It's so tiny. It's a mini special edition. Really cool, really cool. Looks little, plays big. Yeah, I can agree on that. And this is a funky or weird looking speaker. Says 15 plus hours of playtime. Waterproof. I do have one of these ultimate speaker. That's good, yeah. Serves my purpose. TCL brand TV here. What else is interesting here? Look at those big teddy bears on the corner. This is a Samsung Galaxy Flip phone. Actually, I never have had a hands-on experience. Feels good. Not for me though. More Samsung phones here. I'm slightly out of sync with the Samsung now because I've been an iPhone user since last 2 years. But no comparison here. What else do we have? HomePod Mini. I think it's some sort of a speaker, isn't it? Probably. They only have cards here. I think mostly from a security perspective. You just take the card to the checkouts and they do the actual billing and give you the actual device. I do have one of these. Not too sure how much I paid. It says $499 here. I definitely didn't pay that much because I probably took it in during the Christmas on a deal. More headphones, Sony voice noise cancellation. What's this? Some cameras. This is interesting. It's an actual 3D printer. A few years back, it was, 3D printer was very, I don't know. Wouldn't see it that often, but yeah, now you see it everywhere. This is a purse. Yeah, that's a bit more premium price than I thought.
You best be careful.
A full-sized Halloween monster. This is $199.97. Good mix of Halloween stuff here. I'm just walking around, as you can see. There's some pillows. What is this? I think a beanbag. There's lots to see here, lots. If you don't come planned what to buy, you probably can get lost and end up buying something which you don't need. There's some clothing merchandise here. I again don't know about the prices because I haven't compared it with the latest pricing what's out there, but there are a couple of branded clothes I could see, and there is a oven. Okay, there are some cookware. Yep, interesting. It seems heavy. It's what, $429. for $30 for 10 pieces. Not bad. I don't know if it's a non-stick one. Let's have a look. There's a steel version here, scan pan. These seems a bit more solid. I'm a steel utensil or cookware fan these days, just with the health benefits, etc., etc. Moving down, more options. There is a pack of two, $69 or $70. KitchenAid. This seems actually very heavy and solid. I actually needed one of those. Again, as I said, I don't have a trolley today, so just walking around, and probably the second visit I'll actually know what should I be buying. I think that's a good way, because if I'm walking into a new shop, I don't know where is what, and in terms of pricing, I just don't want to buy anything blindly. Although I don't want to again end up buying which I don't need. So more cookery and pottery, the chopping dish. Let's keep walking, and okay, that's interesting. There's engine oil here in the middle of everything else. That's good. There's butane canisters, pack of six. Seems good for camping. Heavy duty battery box. Haven't seen those before. Portable power station. That's very cool. I don't know what's a backup like, but $199. You can't go wrong, I think, in that. What is this? Okay, this is a car jump start. It looks pretty sleek. $129. If your car battery is down, you need a jump start. That's handy. Some tools. What's this? Okay, this is interesting. Soap and suds. I think this one connects to your normal hose pipe and actually makes a bit of foam to wash your car. So generally, we pay about $2 or $3 for, I think, 60 seconds to. Okay, moving on. Again, I'm just walking through the aisles and exploring. There's a switchboard here, some options of lights, and I think interior decoration. Not for me, but I'm just going to have a quick look and walk straight out. This is the emptiest aisle I've seen. Obviously, no one is here. What is this? Some sort of work light. That's cool. $50. Bad. That is good. Again, work lights. As I said, there's actually no one in the aisle, but the rest of the aisles are pretty much packed in terms of, I guess, what people need on a daily basis. This is something which they generally might come with a bit of planning, that they exactly need to buy this. This is very cool. I always wanted this. A bit of retro lighting. More lights. $74. Look, these prices probably don't mean anything to me now. As I said, I haven't actually compared these prices. But look, the range itself, it seems reasonable. Pretty good. The other shop's called Bunnings and Microton as well. They do offer similar kind of range. This is good. What is this? I wonder how do you install this. I'll probably have to pay more installation fees than the actual unit cost. Duracell. Okay, this is my favorite aisle. The grocery aisle. Veggie chips. How much is this? It's a big packet. Probably 1 kg. It has... okay, this is $12.99. Not today. There's some dried mushrooms. Copper kettle chips, my favorite. That's a 50 pack. Never seen that big pack before. There's also ready salted original chippies. What is this? Okay, I think date and walnuts. Nice combination. It must be, freeze dried, because the packet looks very light. $70.99 for cranberries. This is ginger. I think it's sweetened ginger. I have tried it before, not this brand, but just a loose one from other supermarket. But this is a big pack though, because last time I bought was, I think, 50 grams. More than 3-4 months, I still have half left out of it. What's this? Dried longan. I don't have a clue what it is. The pricing seems to be same for most of the nuts. Interesting how they're able to maintain it. More chippies and snacks in this aisle. This was the one I was talking about. If you have not tried this, highly recommend this flavor barbecue. Just amazing. Dried strawberries, not for me. How much is this? $12. You get fresh strawberry for that. Probably cheaper than that. Some rice crackers, 12 variety pack. There's a sampling station here. I think the man is busy prepping the next set of samples. It's a sweet potato stick. Interesting. There's another sampling counter here. Looks like some sort of pancakes. I think red bean paste pancake. Not for me again. Moving on to the chillers. Fresh tofu. How much is this? $6 for a big pack. Not bad. Some extra firm tofu. There's a big tub of yogurt for $6. 850 ml. Not bad. I think all the flavored yogurts and everything else is here. There's pressed tofu. Extra firm. There's again authentic Greek yogurt, $6.59. That's a good value actually. I know that price is generally above $7 in most of the supermarkets. Whipped cream, phyllo pastry, Philadelphia creamy cheese. A lot of good stuff if you are into baking. This is interesting. There's a big 2 kg tub of feta cheese. Not sure about the prices. I generally buy small, tiny little 100 or 200 grams. Never bought a 2 kg feta cheese tub. Good for big families or probably even for restaurants, I guess. What's this? Tasty cheese, grated, easy. Yeah, easy to use, I guess. I definitely need one of those. We generally get the 1 kg block, which is pretty hard to grate urgently when you need it instantly. What's all this? I think more islands and the tasting session and the feta cheese I was talking about. Just a couple of pictures. Moving on. Island here, I think baking stuff. It's panko breadcrumbs. This is, I think the Japanese style breadcrumbs. Gives you nice crispy deep fry items if you want. Walnuts, big packet again. Kirkland, I think, is their own brand. A lot of Kirkland products. Almonds, $22.99. I think it's Australian product. Just about 1 kg, not bad again. Yeah, good value. Hazelnuts. There's a big bottle of cinnamon. Again, yeah, not for our family. We probably end up using a very tiny little bottle, 50 grams, once in 2 or 3 months. Just the storage space, I guess. But some of the items are definitely worth it. What else? More clothing, merchandise here. For some reason, it's a bit quiet in this island section. Probably people are more into meat and grocery. Actually, I haven't got a chance to go into the meat aisle in this video. Probably I'll do a second video covering bits and pieces what I forgot. As I said, the place is huge, so you'll need to do some planning or at least come for a walk or stroll to see where is what, and I guess probably do a bit of study what exactly you need to take back home. But if you're just into a bit of random shopping, it's still definitely worth a visit. That's interesting. The MRP seems pretty high, $214. That price is much cheaper than that. That is the Kirkland, I think the home branded clothing. Your quality seems okay. There are a few colors here. Belt, yeah. Levi's, Calvin Klein. $39.99 men's polo. But the quality seems really good. $40, probably worth it. Yeah. More stuff around on the left and right side. What I'll do is I'll keep walking and probably explore some more interesting areas. What's this? Winter is almost coming to an end. It's not a robe, it's a men's robe. Interesting. Look at these beautiful colors. Definitely flowers is something which is expensive all across Auckland or New Zealand. But this seems reasonable. A bunch of big flowers retailing at, how much is it? I think everything is priced the same here. Good, definitely good variety, and it's $49.50. I think it's worth it, yeah. Big bottle of sun-dried tomatoes and olive oil. What's this? Again, a lot of seafood varieties. These are the canned tuna. And yeah, all these I've seen it in local supermarkets generally. But here you obviously have to buy a pack of 12. That is $18. Yeah, just $1.50 roughly. Yeah. And another backpack, tuna and spring water, $17 for backpack, and this is tuna and chili oil. Most of them seem to be pack of 12. And moving on. What else do we have here on the left side? Some gherkin pickles, I think. The bottle is too heavy. I'm just afraid I'll break it, so I'll leave it alone. Then, what is this? Chili peppers, spicy hot cream peppers. $22 for a big bottle. Yeah, some of them are American products and probably being introduced in New Zealand, which the locals haven't seen it before. But obviously, if you're a foodie, you'll make something out of it. This is Edgel chickpeas. Again, a big pack. Generally, I get one or two for the household. There's another. What is this? Pork floss. Not too sure what is it. This is canned chicken breast, $30 for a pack of 6. Interesting, never seen that before. What's this? Spam meat, classic, 3 to 340 grams, $16.49. Moving on to the next bits, more canned food here. This aisle was pretty much canned food. It's good to have everything on one side. Just makes it easy, I guess, for the buyers. What else do we have here? Baby stuff, wet wipes, $42.99. Health and beauty, Neutrogena, I think body wash, hand wash. What is this? Fancy looking body wash bottle. I think it's a ceramic bottle. Anyways, more stuff, $12 for Himalayan salt. Is that Himalayan? Yeah, bath salt. Epsom bath salt. Never used it before, but I've heard some good health benefits. Some big packs of toothpaste, Sensodyne, pack of 3, $28.99. What else do we have? We have Colgate, again, I think similar, pack of 2 or 3. 3, yeah. 3 seems to be the bare minimum if you're buying health and beauty. Look at the pack of toothbrush. It's a 8-pack, good for a big family. Sensitive Plus, yeah, shaving blades, lots of them, lots again. Yeah, more varieties. This is Venus, comfortable white tea, 12 plus 1. Yeah. Gillette Fusion, let's see, this is my stuff, $14.98 for 3. That is worth it, absolutely. Yes and no, because 3 is quite a bit. It probably will last me for a whole year, but on the pricing side, it's cheaper. Gillette Mac 3, wow, that's a big pack. More shaving razors. The entire aisle is pretty much personal hygiene and health and beauty. Kisses milk chocolate, very popular. That's a very big bag, 330 pieces. That's cool. Everybody loves them, I guess. If you haven't, do give them a go. Jelly beans, Kirkland, again homemade. Okay, so that I think I've pretty much covered most of it in terms of what I wanted to check out. As I said, I haven't go into the meat section probably in the next aisle. This is the very popular food court. I think you can order it on a little kiosk there, and you have to wait for your turn. As you can see, it's super busy. I couldn't manage to buy anything today because there was a bit of waiting for the actual checkouts. So I hope this video was useful. Please feel free to leave your comments and feedback if you have any. These are the big teddy bears which everyone is talking in the town. They actually are full size, like a big one. I'll walk out now. So that's my little excursion to Costco. Costco Wholesale, it says join us now. That's a queue for membership if you haven't done it before. I think they're about 15-20 minutes, you can get it done easily. The machines are pretty fast to print out the actual card, and they take the photo then and there. It costs 60 New Zealand dollars to become a member for 1 year. It says fully refundable if you're not satisfied. That's the exterior building. Costco wholesale. It took me about 30 to 40 minutes to walk around. Obviously I did it in my own speed with some videos too, but all in all I think I'll definitely come back and explore a bit more. I now know what I need to buy and obviously make a proper list of what I'm going to buy and what I'm going to spend in terms of Costco purchases versus other. So goodbye Costco and see you soon. And for the viewers, thanks for watching the video, and if you like it, do hit the like button and leave me your comments. Have a nice day.